Hey guys, Varun Marathe here, and in this video I'm going to do the unboxing of Samsung Galaxy A70. So before I begin, I would love if you could subscribe to my channel so that I can bring you more such videos. And I would also like to thank my sponsor Bridge Solutions Private Limited. It is a Samsung smart cafe located in Thergao, Pune, with all the new devices which are available for sale and also for demo unit for you to see, and with all the original accessories from Samsung as well. So without a further ado, let's begin with the unboxing. On the box we have the blue color variant because this is what I have with me today. On the back there are some specifications, and on the top of the device we have the price, which is written is 30,900 Indian rupees, but it is available for 28,900. So let's get into the box now. As soon as you remove the box, we see the device in the front, which is nicely wrapped in the plastic. So keeping the device on the side over here, what else we get in the box is we have this time a larger brick than usual because this is a 25 watt charger from Samsung, which is a fast, super fast charger from Samsung this time around, so it is going to rapidly charge your device. Another thing that we have in the box is the in-ear headphones which are there, and this is nice from Samsung because these are little bit better than the earphones that they are giving with the previous series devices. This time around, type C to type C charging cable, as the brick has the type C connector port to it. This is a new thing that we are seeing from Samsung, and I think people are going to have mixed views about it. So keeping everything else aside on the box, we have one more thing which is hidden in the top shelf of the box, that is the warranty information and the cover which is there. So we also get a jelly case, which is really nice from Samsung, as we have some added protection right out of the box. So keeping everything on the side and removing the plastic of the device over here, we have the glorious device in front of us, and as you can see it is slightly taller. We have the light blue variant which is there, and it looks really good. We have certain reflections on it as well. The phone is not made of glass or any way, but it does look like glass because of the reflections. So on the front over here, as you can see, we have the Infinity U display from Samsung which is there. On the top we have the noise cancelling microphone. On the right we have the volume rockers and the power button. On the bottom we have the single firing speaker, the microphone, USB type C port, and the 3.5mm adapter. On the right over here we have the slot for a SIM card and micro SD card. So taking a look at the device now and powering it on for the very first time, if it has any juice, it does. So by the time it is getting powered up, I'll give you the specifications overview. Samsung Galaxy A70 is on the front is having 6.7 inch 2400x1080p Super AMOLED Infinity U display. It is powered by 2.2 GHz octa-core Snapdragon 675 processor and Adreno 612 GPU. It has 6GB of RAM and 128GB of internal storage, which is expandable up to 512GB. We have 32MP plus 8MP plus 5MP rear camera. We have 32MP selfie camera and in-display fingerprint scanner. We are having 4500mAh battery, which is chargeable with the super fast charging available in the box. It retails for 28,990 and it's available in 3 colors, that is blue, black and white. So without further ado, let's get into the initial setup. I'll fast forward it as it takes some time. And we have to set the in-display fingerprint scanner as well. Yeah, so here it is. We are in the actual device, and as you can see, the front is all display. The 6.7 inch Super AMOLED Infinity display looks fabulous on the front over here. And as you can see, the brightness is full, and we have the adaptive brightness over here. So right off the back, I would say the brightness of the device is not that high as compared to A50 or A30, and but I think there's considerable amount of light in it, which is natural light, and you are easily able to see the display. And as you expect, that the Super AMOLED display looks gorgeous. Talking about the user interface, I would confirm that it is running One UI version 1.1, which is based on the Android version 9 Pie right out of the box. So it is really, really nice, and it is the latest software from Samsung as well. Right, the in-hand feel of the device does feel really good, and as you can see on the back, we have that triple camera setup with the LED light and the Samsung logo. It looks really, really good on the back, and it reflects light in a certain way. On the front, we have the 32 megapixel selfie camera, which is really nice and high resolution. Talking about another features of the device, on the front, as you can see, the bezels which are there across the device are really, really narrow, and that makes it easier to hold the device, but it is certainly taller, so it's very risky or difficult to reach the top end of the device without maneuvering the device. And overall, the phone does feel really good. The rim which is going across the device, it is also made up of high grade plastic, and on the back is the same, but it does not feel like it. So let's test the fingerprint scanner over here. So as you can see, it does take a second to actually recognize the device and unlock the screen. It can also be done when the screen is completely dark, but it takes slightly more time than it takes to unlock when the screen is lit. So I would say on the first impression it is that fast. But the user interface does look really fast. We don't have much bloatware. We have Netflix and some other applications which are installed, so which is a really, really good thing. And overall, I would say that it is looking really good. Going in the camera interface over here, we have this 32 megapixel camera, which is looking really good in the first impressions. And the user interface of the camera is really similar to all the other user interface which is available on the latest Android One UI software skin which is there. And I would say it is pretty simple to use. We have that ultra wide button as well. Now going in the settings of the camera over here, we would see that the phone is capable of recording up to 4K from the rear camera, and it is capable of recording up to 1080p at 30 frames per second from the front camera. So talking about some other features of the device over here, I would say the phone does not feel really heavy. The main reason for it is that it is made up of plastic, so they have kept the weight low. It also supports Dolby Atmos, but only from headphones or Bluetooth headsets. And we do not have a Bixby key around, so they have given a feature of using the power button as the Bixby key. So all in all, I would say that Samsung has made a really great device out of this. Yeah, it is a little bit costly, coming in around 28,990 Indian rupees. So it is the costliest A series phone so far in India. We are waiting for the launch of A80, which will be sometime in next month, so that is going to be more costly. And I would think that Samsung has given some features in it with the bigger display, the bigger battery, also the fast charging, which is a super fast charging, which is first of its kind in Samsung devices. So they have tried to differentiate the device from the other A series device. So whatever you think about this device, please feel free to write in the comments. If you like the video, guys, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in my next video. Peace.